Hey, it's Velma. Let's go solve some mysteries, Scoobs. It's the Friday Doodle Diary. Hey, messy room 2014 update.
It may have gotten worse.
It may have gotten just really bad. There's, God, everything everywhere. Because I thought it would be a really good idea. I'm gonna put glasses on to complete this outfit. I thought it would be a good idea to rearrange and get a new desk around the holiday season when we're at our busiest. Sure, why not? What was I gonna say? Oh, this has been a weird week. This has been a very weird week. Yesterday was kind of tragic. Let's start with the bad news, because that's how you traditionally do it. You lead with the awful things. We said goodbye to Congressman Phineas J. Underwood, the fish, yesterday. It was sad. So we got him for, there's this aquaponics plant growing tank where the fish is underneath the plants and it pumps water up to the plants and the fish poo feeds the plants. And awesome in theory. It was a little more complex, a lot more maintenance than I thought initially. So, you know, we got it to work, but there's just things like they don't mention about fish care. Like if you get something like that, you got to read up on taking care of the fish. So he got what I believe, according to my internet searching, it's like a bladder bloat problem. If they get too much of the same food variety, that can happen. And so he kind of like had these, like he had his good days and his bad days. And I was trying to like bring the water to like a nice super clean level, but like with the live bacteria, cause you don't want it too clean. And then like he would get better and then get worse. And then finally like, he's like, I give up on this. And I'm like, sorry, man, so sorry. Fish are so, like, you can't feed them too much, but you gotta feed them enough. And there's gotta be enough bacteria, but there can't be too much bacteria, but if you get rid of all the bacteria, it's off. So yeah, that's kind of sad. And very, very strange. I was scooping out the fish tank yesterday, cleaning up, and so we're gonna get into the gory details of disposing of a body, but because he had this bloat thing, he didn't float like fish usually do. He was at the bottom, and I didn't want to reach in, and I didn't have a net, and I was like, you know what, I'll just like get as much water out of the tank and then scoop him off to Valhalla. So I was just sitting there scooping water out of this tank into a bucket, old school style, very slow, very meditative. It's kind of very cathartic in a very interesting way. I can't explain it. I don't want to say it was a good thing, but it's like, this feels like a part of a process. Like this is a very necessary thing. But it was also very creepy because then it causes the water to slosh around and then he starts like floating in it. And I'm like, oh, is he? No, he's gone. He's been at the bottom of the tank all day. Yeah, so that's one of the things going on yesterday. Also, on top of that, because that morning I woke up and I checked on him and I was like, I think he's left us. I couldn't quite tell because he was like behind a thing. And then we had an appointment though to go to a float tank. So I was like, okay, I'll go to the float tank, come home, assess the situation. Float tank, Dante and I went to sensory deprivation tank where, and you may have, if you watch The Simpsons, they reference this. I think Lisa goes into one in an episode. So it's completely black, blocked out light, blocked out sound as best as possible. And you also have earplugs in your ears because you're gonna be laying flat in a solution of water and salts. Like it's like a super thick saline solution and there's other stuff in there for cleanliness purposes, but you float. So you're in this cold, dark, not cold, it's warm. You're in a dark, warm, like it's a nice warm, like ooh, dark, warm, soundless tank, completely black. And you float for 2 hours, we did. It's very interesting. People have stories of going into sensory deprivation tanks where they see colors and they have all these revelations. And you do, when you come out and start talking about what you're thinking of in the tank, it sounds like you've just been smoking weed, man. Hey, Scoobs, let's go solve a mystery. But it's very interesting. I was appreciating just the physicality of it, because you're just floating and you got to try to let everything go, but your body still wants to tense up. The guy mentioned, and I experienced, that you get this neck tension, and it's 2 hours, so you can like change up your arms where you put them. And I was also enjoying doing like little isolation movements without the gravity, because after a while you're floating, and I forgot for a good amount of time that I was on my back, and I just kind of felt like I was upright. If there is an upright, is there an up, is there a down? I just kind of felt like I was in a void. And you get these weird sensations, or both Dante and I got this, where when you're in the tank, you might bump into a wall here and there, and I just kind of push away just a little bit. But that slight motion of moving over felt like you were flying, like being pulled. So like you hit the wall and you go, wah! In your mind, but you're not doing that in real life. It's hard to explain. I thought so hard on rock, paper, scissors. There was a phase where I was like, I was trying to figure out, what is it that paper does to rock that thwarts it? What is it that paper does to rock? What could it possibly be? I was brainstorming that. It's like a think session or meditation session. Breathing helped. Dante advised, like, he talked to me about meditation breathing, and he's like, yeah, just focus on breath. And in those moments where you start panicking about being in a black tomb that is completely black when you open your eyes, there's no difference between having your eyes closed and having your eyes open. It helps to breathe and just let everything relax. But just thoughts, waves of thoughts, because you get a thought coming and then you start chasing that and following that rabbit hole. And then you really come back and you become hyper aware of your physical existence and like where you are in this tank. And then you start chasing another thought and you go off and you become hyper aware of where you're at. It was fun. It was definitely worth doing once. It's not something where I'm like, you have to do this. This is so amazing. It's a cool experience. We went to Float Labs in Venice Beach. It's the same guy that, I guess he built a tank for Joe Rogan, if you listen to the Joe Rogan podcast. It was cool. I got so much saline solution in my mouth when I stood up, though, at the end of it, because we were in there for 2 hours. And by the end, like toward the end of the 2 hours, I was feeling like, okay, I think I get it. I got what I need. Kind of feel like I should move. So then the guy, like, he yells, like, you're all done in there. He's like, yes. So I sit up and the solution just like dripped out of my hair into my mouth. And I thought it was gonna be like a super, super salt water. It was like this, it had a very bitter chemical-y taste. I was like, but it made your skin very soft by the end of it. So I got it in my mouth and I instinctively like lean over to wipe it out, and then it drips into my eyes. I'm like going blind and feeling for the door, and the guy puts a towel on the door in case you get solution in your eyes while you're in there. I think it's also so you can easily find the door and not freak out. But it was farther behind me than I thought it would be, so I sit up, but where's the door? Oh God! Oh, there it is. I'm blind! And I was blind when I got out. I had to run to the shower like, ah. It was super fun. Super fun. But yeah, it was a day of thinking and pondering and, you know, saying goodbye, but that contemplative. Yeah, every now and then you just gotta like go in and scoop the water out of your dead fish's tank and think about stuff. It's that slow meditative thinking. Yeah. Well, on that note, I gotta go right here now and shoot some more tutorials. Ah! And maybe clean the room. I don't know. And ship out some paintings. Oh, sweet. I hope you have a wonderful week. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next week. Beep. I'm also gonna go solve a mystery.